I'm your host, Marty Shields. And tonight we're coming to you live from the Baldwin Park Performing Arts Center in beautiful downtown Baldwin Park. Hi, hey! Now I have to admit, I'm a little nervous tonight. In fact, I was sweating a little bit backstage. In fact, I come from a long line of sweaters. Dad was a turtleneck and Mom was a cashmere. So. That's true. I only received one union telegram this evening. That was from Tanya Harding, who told me to break a leg. That's right. It's true. Just recently in the news, apparently they found some life on the planet Mars. See that in the news? You ever see that, huh? Life on the planet Mars. And the interesting thing is, they found out the DNA was the same as OJ's. That's right. No? Also in the news recently, a lady is going to have 8 babies in England. Oh my goodness, we got feedback. We're live, as you can tell. A lady in England is going to have 8 babies. See that? It's kind of like a litter. 8 babies. And I guess they just announced the other day the father of the 8 babies. It was none other than our corner band. That's right, the corner band. Anybody like candy? You guys eat candy? A candy? Oh. Grew up on candy. Apparently the makers of Pez. Remember Pez, the little guy in the head, and he pops up? Well, apparently the makers of Pez have now made a semi-automatic candy dispenser. That's right. The bad thing is you have to wait 5 days before you can buy the candy. See, semi-automatic, it's a joke. It's kind of play off. Tough crowd tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Did you see where the Miss Universe has been in some trouble with the pageant? Apparently she's gained about 27 pounds since she, 27 pounds, getting a little big there, eating too much. And I guess they've threatened to take away her crown unless she drops the 27 pounds. And if she doesn't drop the 27 pounds, next year at the pageant, we're gonna have a new competition, all you can eat. That's right, all you can eat. All you can eat. Is there anybody out there? We're celebrating our 3rd anniversary here on Marty. It's been 3 years on TCI, 3 years, huh? And we're also doing something else here tonight. We're raising money for a fund that we're involved in here at TCI and also the corner, which is the Small Grants for Literacy. So thank you all for supporting that, huh? Small Grants for Literacy. We have a good show for you here. I said our 31st show, I think. Mike, yes. Is that about 31st, yes. Huh? Uh-huh. Boy, way too many shows. Let me go ahead and read off the performers who will be here tonight. We have comedian Charlie Marco. Charlie Marco is here. An old friend of the corner, Rick Stein, is back again. Rick Stein, crazy Rick Stein. A comedian and an impersonator, and you're just gonna love this gentleman. Alex Pages is here tonight. Alex Pages, somewhere over here. We have 2 dance troupes for your pleasure tonight. The first one is a lady who was actually on our first show 3 years ago. She'll be coming on with The Sultan's Delight. Fatim is here. Fatim is here tonight. Some belly dancing. We have a local group who will be performing some ballet folklorico for your pleasure. Tone Anzine is here tonight. Tone Anzine! Yeah. Our musical guests include a gentleman who's started back in the 50s and a great rock and roll rockabilly act. Glenn Glenn is here tonight again. Glenn Glenn, coming back to the corner. A group of 4 guys from Russia, and you're gonna love them. They tore the house down when they played in our studio in February. The Red Elvises are here, the Red Elvises! And we're really happy having 2 groups on the show who are making their first appearance here on Marty's Corner. Both of these acts had number 1 hits in America. The first act would be somebody that I grew up with back in the 70s. Bo Donaldson and the Haywoods are here. Bo Donaldson and the Haywoods are here tonight. And last but surely not least, a lady who we all love, the original Angel Baby herself. Rosie and the Originals are here. Rosie and the Originals! I hear her. We'd like to start off with a group of gentlemen who, interesting enough, they auditioned for me in my driveway about midnight after the show one night. Yeah! And we weren't sure if they were that good or if we had way too many. We don't know, but they're back here tonight, and we're so glad to have them back. Can you please give a warm welcome to Paul and George, The Show. The Show, where are you guys? The Show, here they are, come on back, hey. You guys, take it away.
How you guys doing tonight? All right, you guys ready? All right. Just gonna kill a little time here. Get the mic set up. My car started making a funny noise today. That's all I have to say.
We're gonna do a song called Shoestrings, a song that I made up when I was working at a coffee house. And you know, a lot of shady things can go on in coffee houses, especially in Covina. But anyways, here we go.
Her hair hangs wet in the sizzling summer night. The concrete maze wasn't blazing the tops, artificial light. The pimp and his ladies in their dark gray Mercedes like to wait for the show to let out. The dykes and the drugs and the pugs and the punks, they are a part of society now. And
I dance for you.
Dance for my fame and fortune.
I dance for you.
Dance for my famous potion.
I dance for you.
I got no time for loving, less time for living. They tell me that a show be so forgiving.
Be ba zi da di ba be do be do wa di de le be ba 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 bo ba do wa.
Skid up and do down deep dab de do de do do de do do do. The police gorilla, he's a meat-eating killer. He stands alone and flips a coin in the air. If you do something wrong, he's gonna break every bone from the law to the sand. Laissez-faire, then there's me in the middle with the sweet paradiddle. Like leather on theater boards, you see the dance is a thing. First you sweat, then you swing. Sometimes you sit on your hands and you bleed.
I dance for you.
Dance for my fame and fortune.
I dance for you.
Dance for my famous potion.
I
got no time for loving, less time for living. They tell me that a showbiz is so forgiving. The show lets out. Broadway rhythms come to life. The chinchilla and mink and the smell of Chanel number five. The cafe is full of the large and the small. There's praising and there's poison and I'm used to it all. The big shots will strut and the leeches will creep. The newcomer farted and the has-beens will weep. The Big Apple loves us like shepherd loves sheep. They shoot me while I dance for my keep.
I dance for you.
Dance for my fame and fortune.
I dance for you.
Dance for my famous potion.
I dance for
you. I got no time for loving, less time for living. They tell me that a showbiz is so forgiving.
Beep, beep, bop, bop, hop, zip, bap, no joke. Doobly doo, bop, boo, bop, and a scooby doo.
Dee da, doo da, deep da, be da, 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 doo da, dee do, dee do, dee do. I dance for you.
Thank you.
Good show. George, thank you. Paul, good to see you. Good to see you. The show. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back, guys. Get each other.
Marty Shields, introducing Channel 33's new fall lineup here. Watch my show, Marty's Corner, Fridays at 8, starting August 20th.
Get a jump, Marty.
About half the time, they're musicians. Welcome back. In the 3 years we've done the show, I've had the opportunity of working with two co-hosts, sidekicks slash announcers, and the lady who is now with us on the corner is not only a wit and a little bit pushy, but we love her. So let's take a look at the video clip here in the hall at my co-host. Take it away, Skip. Let it rip. Whatever time you're ready. Watch the monitor here in the...
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are.
We have a somebody sitting with us tonight, our co-host, Leanne Engel. Leanne!
What better time than Valentine's Day to say those three little words I often think but seldom say? Are you done? Have a Hello.
Yeah. Hello, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
What brings you up here right in the middle of the show?
Well, because I was trying to make my way over to the couch.
Go ahead.
Yeah, someone knows how to eat.
Yes.
Yes, Mike knows how to eat.
Fabulous.
Very good. Thank you.
Now, I have a little gift for you.
All right.
And it's something for the holiday season. You might even be able to wear it this evening.
This is great.
And open it up so, you know, we can see.
Oh, thank you, Leanne. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Wow. This is a cut.
It's to remind you of last year.
The lipstick. That's
the
right.
Red lipstick.
Last year, Leanne actually made me up look like a girl on the air, and
there we are.
Oh, here's a shot of it. Oh, you.
Look at those luscious lips. Woo!
Believe it or not, we have a good show for you here in Marty's Corner. Our 20.
Excuse me.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm here to deliver some flowers.
Oh,
they're probably for Leanne, right?
I'm sorry. These are for a Mr. Frank Intensio.
Oh, I'm sorry. Over there. Oh. Sorry, babe.
What about me?
Oh, sit down. It's okay. We're gonna hook you up, Billy. How are you doing today?
Gonna hook me up. Hi.
Hook you up. Hey. No. At this time, I'd like to bring on my co-host slash announcer slash sidekick, the beautiful and talented Miss Leanne Engel. Leanne, come on out! Hey!
Oh, you're We can't get that close.
You stand over there. We want to feed back on everyone. Well, how are you doing?
Wonderful, since that's the first time I've seen that clip.
Oh, sorry about that. We've had Leanne for about a year now.
Yes.
And what do you like best about the show, Leanne?
The spontaneity.
Spontaneity?
That we have, yes.
And that was not rehearsed, as you could tell. At this time, I'd like to go ahead and do something you do every month on Marty's Corner, which is our top nine list. Top nine list on Marty's Corner, which is compiled by our home office here in Baldwin Park. That's right, Baldwin Park. Now, in choosing a venue for our anniversary show, we went to a lot of places, actually. We went to a couple of playhouses, and we came in here, and we loved this place, but we had to be sold. We had to be sold on it. So working with some of the staff here, we came to an agreement to bring our show to the Baldwin Park Center here tonight. And there were a couple other reasons why we did, too. So if we go ahead and bring up the top nine list here in the hall, Have that, please. Top 9 list of Marty's Corner, which is, if I could see that, please, gentlemen. Top 9 reasons Baldwin Park was chosen for this show. Number 9. Corner band thought it was an actual park with rides and stuff. Woo! Okay. Number 8. Wes Covina still mad about that Macarena fiasco. Whoa. Number 7 on our list is, I thought they said Buena Park. We didn't know.
Buena Park.
Sorry. Number 6 on our list is, please outbid the Democrats for the building. That's right.
All right.
Put a political humor for you people on Baldwin Park. Number 5 on our list is, please, wanted to meet the Baldwins, Al and Billy. That's right, Baldwin.
Yeah.
Number 4 on our list is, Psychic Friends recommended it. That's right, Psychic Friends.
Yeah.
I don't believe in that stuff. Number 3 on our list is, 3, please. Oh my goodness, here we go. Where is it? Oh, we're having time with the summer.
It's live.
I'm just going to say it, ain't I? Okay, number 3. If the show doesn't work out, we can learn to trade next door at the training center. Oh!
Yeah!
Number 2 on our list is, oh, we're back here. A local assemblyman loves the name of the show. Inside joke.
All right, Marty's Corner.
And the number 1, 3 words, my own dressing room. Now, where does it say on the script that Marty ad-libs in segment 2?
It doesn't.
I don't see it. As we're performing tonight, we have a bunch of performers backstage in the green room. Ooh, backstage,
ooh,
huh?
Ooh.
There's a party going on back there.
Yeah.
And we've enlisted our own crazy Mike Harrington, and he's back there kind of pumping up the crowd, getting the performers ready, so when they come out here, they give you a hell of a show. You want a hell of a show, don't you?
Yeah!
So, with the technology here at TCI, we're going to go live backstage with our crazy Mike and see what he's doing. Mike, where are you? Take it away, crazy Mike, backstage. Yeah!
Hey!
Oh, my goodness.
Well, they look good. I don't know about Mike.
I know they're good. Yeah, he's having too much fun back there, huh? I know
you do. Yeah, I know you do. Oh, yeah. Can you do that?
I can't do that at all. Oh, we've had way too much. Let me go into the back door camera here. Get away from Mike. Oh, crazy Mike Harrington, ladies and gentlemen. Crazy Mike. Taylor having a blast backstage. We need to go away for a 3-minute break.
Yes.
We'll be right back. Don't go away, guys. Could you please? Yeah, come on. Gentlemen behind us have been with us for 3 years, bringing the sound of Marty's Corner to the Valley. And if we could, let's go ahead and we're going to close the curtains up and show the B-roll. So let's go and close the curtains. And I'm going to get out of the way here. We're going to lose our cameramen. Oh, there they go. There we go. Whoa, Nelly. Hey, I do it all. So if we could, let's go ahead and take a look. Let's take a look. I'm going to spotlight. Let's take a look at the monitor here in the audience. And the best of the corner band of the last 3 years. Take it away in the truck, Skip.
One, two, ready, go.
Woo!
I want peace on earth and goodwill towards men.
Okay. This is our bass player, Albert. Albert, what do you want for the new year?
Beer, beer, and more beer.
Oh! And way in the back, we got Jim. Jim, what do you want for a happy new year?
A better economy so we can all make more money.
Yeah. What a wicked thing to say. You never felt this way.
The guys in the band were on Rice Krispies. Here's a shot of the band. And I want to know which one of you guys is Snap. I know who Crackle is. I want to know who Snap is. We appreciate you talking to us. And wait, Frank wants to say something to you.
Mom, can you have those shirts done by Monday? Thanks, Mom. I love you.
Okay.
The best rock band and variety talk show in the San Gabriel Valley, at least, our own The Corner Band. The Corner Band, ladies and gentlemen! The Corner Band! The Curtain! The Corner Band!
Thank you. Everybody's gonna move their feet. Get down. Everybody's gonna leave their seat.
Yeah! 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 The Corner Band! The Corner Band! Thank you! Thank you! Thank you!
Thanks, Marty. Happy anniversary.
Thank you, guys. Close the curtain up. Oh, Jesus, God, something just fell. We're live, ladies and gentlemen, as you can tell. How you doing? We'd like to go ahead and show another videotape of the last 3 years on the corner, some of the more lighthearted moments. So could you please go ahead and roll that video one more time in the hall? Guys, take it away. Watch your screen right here in the hall.
What kind of suggestions can you give to people that are actually out there drinking? I mean, what you know, I'm a big guy and I have a tendency to drink a lot too, but I hold it pretty well, at least I think I do. What is the actual, what can I drink without actually getting ripped out of my mind?
Milk, water, and pop.
Milk, water.
But there was a lot of obstacles over the last past 3 years that you and your wife both overcame.
That is right on. That is exactly right. That is too funny. Yes.
Seriously,
right.
Marty.
You are right.
Hey, so,
hey, man.
Hey.
Hey, it doesn't matter.
We'll be right back to the commercial. Don't go away, guys. Get us out of here, ladies and gentlemen. The Armistead.
We have alter ego individual styles here with Heidi Johnson. She has her funky baggy overalls with her 70s funkadelic shirt.
Michelle and Bill. Michelle is wearing her vinyl shorts. She has a bra tank top and a Wild Kitty shirt. Black tin eye steel toes and a paper doll handbag.
And now we need to apply the color, and of course, for the holidays, we need to go with red.
Kissable lips, they call it. Kissable.
Okay, we have Dave. Dave, go for the nose.
Okay, take a nice deep breath in.
Go ahead, Dave.
And exhale.
Your name again is?
Lori.
That's correct.
You're lying.
No. Lori, are you married?
Yes.
Happily?
Yes.
Good. Glad to hear it, Lori.
Work it,
Bill.
No, I'm not. Now, Lori, we have three ropes. Probably ropes very similar to those that you and your husband have in your bedroom, right?
Last week, my agent called me. Said, Rich, I got a big shot for you. Cable show in Hacienda Heights. I said, yeah, pinch me, I'm dreaming.
Right here. There she's coming.
Okay. Oh, thank you. Joining me is the director for the dance troupe that will be performing, Tonin Zim. This is Marguerite, and she's going to tell us what we will be seeing upcoming.
Great. Good evening. It's a pleasure for us to be here with you this evening. What we've brought is some indigenous dances of the Aztecs. You'll be seeing a representation of ceremonial danzas that were performed during festivities. And basically, what you'll be seeing is the entrance to the temple, where they would offer themselves to the deities that were to be worshipped, following different ceremonial dances for the gods.
And real quick, how long has the group been together?
We've been together approximately 12 years and we're based in East Los Angeles.
Okay, and is there a number that they can get in touch with you if they're interested in you performing?
Yes, 213-7331.
Okay, and without further ado, here they are. You can find the opening. Where is it? Give me a curtain. There we go. We'll be right back.
this is Oscar De La Hoya, and I want to wish Marty's Corner a happy anniversary.
A gentleman who has appeared on Marty's Corner a couple months ago. And unfortunately, he was upstaged by a pygmy goat, but you know, that's what happens in live TV. But luckily, he is also an MC at the Pasadena Ice House, so you can catch him there. And he is a very, very funny man, so help me welcome Charlie Marco.
Thanks, Leanne. Folks, keep it going for Leanne. That's Leanne. Keep it going for her. Come on. And hey, how about a big hand for all the people that have made this show possible for 3 years? 3 years, for keep it going for them. Come on, work it out, come on. These people have been working 3 years, keep it going. Yeah. Come on, folks, work it out. People in back, people in the upper balcony, work it out, come on. I got 8 minutes to kill, keep it going for them. Thanks, so how are we doing? Good, you guys are pumped, cool. It's good to be here in Baldwin Park, as seen in Cops. It's a great place to be. And how about were the dancers great or what? They were incredible, weren't they? And watching them, I was so relieved because, folks, I almost wore the same outfit. It's scary. But anyway, here we are. It's 1996, the end of August. Think of what we got coming up, okay? In about 2 months, we got the new election, okay? Then in 4 years, the year 2000. Then in only 15 years, I'll have good credit. So I'm pretty excited about that. Pretty happy. The summer's almost over. Biggest movie of the summer, Independence Day. Now, how many saw Independence Day? By applause. How many of you guys saw that? Everybody, right? Okay, biggest movie of the summer. Pretty cool movie. Right now, some of the things, though, could never happen. Like with the aliens attack L.A.? If aliens ever attacked L.A., you know what happened? I was attacked by aliens. Larry Parker got me $2.1 million. We would sue their pants off, man. They attacked East L.A.? Yama dos. What happened? It would. But the outer space is the big thing, though. Outer space. You hear about that meteorite from Mars? You hear about that? Now, the meteorite from Mars had evidence of bacteria all over it. Bacteria, that means at one time, Mars had a jack-in-the-box. Radio Shack sound system coming along. Is this coming along okay? Okay, I think the fries are done. I think they are. But anyway, is somebody going to be okay? Are we like, is that a bug zapper or what? Is this thing going to be okay? Okay. But anyway, the big thing about outer space, there might actually be life in outer space. Now, scientists say the only thing necessary to support primitive life is water, oxygen, and a Walmart. That's all you need. Does Baldwin Park have a Walmart? Not yet. We'll get one, though, pretty soon. The special effects, though, in Independence Day were cool, weren't they? Now, one of the neatest movies for special effects was Toy Story. Remember that movie, Toy Story? Set all kinds of frontiers. It was all done with computers. I mean, it looks real, but everything's artificial. Everything's fake. Kind of like Baywatch. It's the same deal. Not that I mind. Now, Independence Day is going to break the record for the biggest movie of the 90s. Currently held by which movie? Anybody know? Jurassic Park. The baby almost got it, but it's Jurassic Park. Now, how many saw Jurassic Park? By applause. How many saw that? Okay, biggest movie of the 90s. And did anybody read the book before they saw the movie? Anybody read the book? And what'd you like better, the book or the movie? What'd you like better, the book or the movie? The book. See, that's why I don't read. No, because I mean, think about it. Doesn't it seem like every time you go to the movies with somebody that reads, they always say the same thing. What do they say? The book was better. Right. Now, you see, this is why I will never sleep with any woman who's read that book, The Joy of Sex. I'd never say, hey, don't Charlie, last night was okay, but the book was better. I mean, don't hear that. Clinton is coming out with his first book. I believe it's the first thing he had published, unless you count those letters to Penthouse Forum. Dear Forum, I'm the leader of a large North American country. But a lot of big trials going on right now. They just completed the Whitewater trial, and they convicted the governor of Arkansas. Now, he's under house arrest, which in Arkansas means you take the wheels off your trailer home. So he's in deep trouble. Jack Kevorkian was found not guilty. You guys agree with that verdict, do you? I'm sure he's happy because now he can go back to work at Kaiser, right? Yeah, Kaiser people here. Way to go, man. And of course, the big Ted Kaczynski Unabomber thing is coming up. Now, I know you're innocent until proven guilty, but by applause, how many think Ted Kaczynski actually is the Unabomber? How many think he is? You know, he's got to be. Have you heard about the evidence? In the cabin, they found a typewriter. They found a bomb. Then in the room behind the cabin, Cato Kalin. He was the Unaloafer. He was. Thank you. Oh, no, please, sit down. We can't continue the show until you sit down. Stay in your seats, please. Thanks for having it for me, though. Oh, I've been doing comedy for about 4 or 5 years. Got some good news I want to share with you, folks. Get this. Just last week, I found out I just got my own game show. I'm going to be the host of my own game show, so I'm pretty excited about that. Yep. It's on Channel 18, the Korean channel. It's called Wheel of Kimchi. So you win a prize, we bury it, you know? You can have the Russian Elvises, the Korean Wink Martindale on the same show. Pretty damn amazing, huh? But the things are happening for me. Just turned 34 recently. I'm thinking about investing. So I went to a stockbroker last week to see which investment would be right for someone with my income. And he suggested Super Lotto. So the lottery's a good thing. See, if I had a lot of money, the first thing I'd do buy a really expensive car, like a Ferrari. Wouldn't it be cool to have a Ferrari? See, if I had a car that expensive, though, every time I parked it, I'd leave the headlights on. See, that would be in the health club working out next to some really hot babe, and you'd hear, with the owner of a red Ferrari. I go, that must be mine. I drive a pretty cool car, too. Currently, I drive a white Vet. Say a 1975 Chevette, which makes it sort of a classic. The only options like AM, FM, A-track, just a chick magnet, man. It's a cool car. Couldn't afford LoJack, so I got Kojak. You try to steal it, goes, who loves you, baby? Who loves you, baby? But I got some advice I want to ask you guys. I was in Hawaii, and I met a woman there. We've been keeping in touch the whole time. Should I do the long-distance relationship thing or not? No. Unless I know it's expensive, isn't it? Big phone bills, like my last girlfriend lived in the 1-900 area code. Oh, man, you talk about a phone. What is that, Mike, like 395 minutes, something like that? It's close, somewhere around there. Hawaii is so cool, though. Anybody been to Hawaii? Anybody been to Hawaii? By applause. You guys been there? Okay, give you some advice. If you go there, go to a luau, go to a good hotel. Go to, like, the Hyatt or the Marriott. Oh, it's at the Motel 6 luau. And that's the drop you have at Denny's and you have to lie and say it's your birthday? That's horrible. The baby liked that joke. Be prepared, though. They have weird names for appetizers. Like, what do they call appetizers? What do they call them? Poo-poos. See, I didn't know that. The waiter comes up to us and says, we have very good poo-poos. I'm like, well, you must be a lot of fiber in your diet. I don't know. I did a poo-poo joke just for the baby. That was for the baby. I want you to know that. Thank you. But love meeting new women. By applause. How many married people here? Married people, by applause, Roya? Okay. Got a real happy group? Okay. Single people? Okay. We're not going home with anybody. We're proud of it. All right. People currently having an affair. We usually bust one guy. We usually do. But I love meeting new women, though. I love first dates because to me, a first date is like a seed. You know, folks, that seed might just someday blossom into the beautiful flower of a relationship. Do you like that? Get rid of that and Hustler. Yeah. You're a sick bunch, man. You guys are. Just joined the health club recently. You seem like you're in pretty good shape. But now, people that don't work out, those have excuses. Do me a favor with this excuse. I'm not fat. I just have big bones. No, maybe, but when's the last time you saw a skeleton with a big butt? It doesn't happen. But anyway, folks, that is the end of my little part of the show. You guys have been a lot of fun. Enjoy the rest of the thing. Happy third anniversary, folks. 3 years. Marty, can you make it out here? Folks, it's Marty Shields.
Are you done?
Yeah.
Okay.
Come on, back up.
Charlie Markle, ladies and gentlemen. Charlie, what do you got coming up real soon?
Tomorrow night I'll be at the Ice House in Pasadena.
Yeah. MC at the Ice House. Charlie Markle. Can we have Charlie out there?
Okay.
Why are you going out? We've got to find the curtain.
Can we make it up?
There's no way to get through here, Charlie.
Wait.
There's no way, Charlie.
I'm just going to have to stay here. I'm sorry.
Okay, that's Charlie Markle, ladies and gentlemen. We're live, as you can tell. We'll find your place, Charlie. Ad-libbing as we go. We'd like to go ahead and run another videotape for you here in the hall. We've got some incredible bands and acts, musical acts in the last 3 years. So let's go ahead, if we could, run that videotape down to us and take a look at some of the musical acts we've had in the last 3 years of Marty's Corner. Please watch your monitor here and take it away, gentlemen, anytime you're ready. 2, 3. Thank you.
the pain that lies deep in our hearts.
Those fingers in my hair, that sly, hithered stare, that strips my conscience bare, it's witchcraft.
To sail across the ocean, show the whole world
my heat by our motion.
Everybody's moving tonight.
Everybody's moving, everybody's moving tonight.
Yes, everybody's moving, everybody's moving tonight. Yeah.
Variety of musical acts on Marty's Corner in the last 3 years. We have one more performer before we're going to take a small intermission to let us go ahead and fix some of the problems we're having. And we'd like you to go out and maybe stretch your legs, buy some of the concessions out there, buy a t-shirt or so. And we'll be back in about a half hour. But what we'd like to do right now is bring out a band who was with us in February. These gentlemen taught Boris Yeltsin how to rock and roll. Yeah. From somewhere in Western Siberia, can you please give a warm welcome to the Red Elvises!
Every morning I wake up, I got a headache and hiccups.
Turn the microphone on.
Tell me what I did last night.
Face and lipstick, nose and blood, hands are shaking. What a sad. My baby left me, but I feel alright.
Please don't tell me what I did last night.
Thank you.
I did last night.
Hello, Marty. Nice to see you again. Nice.
Pretty good.
Ole, on behalf of TCI and the people down here at Ballin Park, we'd like to present you with a plaque.
Oh, yeah. My God!
Anniversary show. There you
Thank
go.
You
I'll
much.
Hold that for you, okay?
That's beautiful.
You also have your new CD, The Red Elvises.
Check it out. Grooving to the Moscow Beat.
Okay.
It's just out last week.
Can you do another song for us real quick?
Of course. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have some... We need some volunteers to dance. We're going to do a... Siberian surf dance. Mm-hmm. Marty, would you help me pick out volunteers?
Marty, do you want to be a volunteer?
Would you like to come on stage? Come on. Yeah. You come on stage. And you too. Come on. Come on, we need beautiful girls on stage. Come on. Please, all four of you.
Thank
come
you.
On, we have no time.
Yeah.
Let's
yeah.
do it.
We're gonna be on it's, TV.
Yeah. It's easy, you don't have to do much, you just stand on stage and look beautiful, right here.
Yeah.
This is, you know, you've seen the Pulp Fiction, that the movie, you dance like that.
Woo!
Ha! Dance anywhere you like. Siberian surf dance. You do the same. Come on! Genesis, ladies and gentlemen.
We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Guys, get us out of here. Play something already.
All right, another Siberian. Let's do the Shubaloo.
What Elvis is, huh?
Come on.
Do it.
Shubaloo.
We've decided to go ahead and start a little bit sooner, but we'd like to get this thing going, so we are back. Is there anybody out there? Hello! We have a dance troupe with a lady who was on our first show, as I mentioned at the beginning of the show, and she's done every anniversary show since then. And she'll be on doing some, I guess, Middle Eastern dancing or Eastern dancing, or I'm sure she'll tell me that I screwed up. Ladies and gentlemen, can you please welcome Sultan's Delight and Fatim? Take it away!
Yeah! Woo! Wow. idiot.
think so, Carmen. Thank you so much, sweetheart. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Fatim and the Sultan's Delight, huh? Let's go and pull the curtain. Why don't you ladies stay right here? Let's go and pull the curtain. We're going to take a look at another video clip. Oh, I can't stand this close up, can I? Oh, they're amazing. We're going to go ahead and take another look at some of the best of the last 3 years. Give us a chance to make some changes backstage. Take it away in the truck, guys, over on the monitor. Best of the last 3 years. Take it away.
Okay, I got a few minutes and I'll be back. Nothing happens, we'll see. Okay.
Y'all
be
up?
I got it. No, that's fine. You don't hear it here.
Yeah, we do.
In here?
Yeah.
Oh, well, where are they at?
For my hairdresser, Danny, who's appearing in this piece by Rachel Rosenthal, and that's Danny is appearing as a throng in this piece.
Throng.
So I'm going to try and see that tomorrow night.
Also, you did your hair recently?
Yes.
Beautiful.
Of a dark 17th century warlock in the horror industry. I get to go around and make appearances at conventions, meet big stars, work with big stars. One of them is Elvira. I've kind of got a little personal thing going with her. She's my little sister and I'm the guy.
Okay. We're out of focus though. What's going on in the control room?
Somebody saw.
John, Craig, are you guys in the control room? Are you guys watching me at all? Randy, let's go see what the heck's going on in the control room. Randy, why don't you come with me? Hold on a second. Keep on my look. Let's see what's going on in the control. Come on, Randy, let's go. Excuse everybody. We're just going to go see what's going on in the control room. Hold on.
Oh, it's been a very nice show. Are you going to the control room right now?
You guys in there? Come on, let's go. What the heck is going on in here? Oh my god, it's Pogs! It's Pogs, ladies and gentlemen! This is Pogs. The newest thing to sweep the United States, Pogs.
Okay, check the video out. Okay, Frank's coming.
Bring up Frank's part.
Microphone for Frank.
He's on one of the band mics.
I'd like to introduce rockabilly legend, Glenn Flynn.
Cigarette, waiting on the one I want to love and pet. It seems like a year since I've seen her face. Her sweet lips sucking away the taste. Waiting on my baby, but she ain't here yet. A cup of coffee and a cigarette. Well, I think I'm gonna cry if she don't show up. Tears gonna gonna fall in the coffee cup. Cigarette smoke's a getting in my eye. That ain't the reason that I cry. Waiting no more, baby, but you ain't here yet. One cup of coffee and a cigarette. Mr. Guitar, right here. Cry if she don't show up. Tears are gonna fall in the coffee cup. Cigarette smoke's getting in my eye. That ain't the reason that I cry. Waiting no more, baby, but she ain't here yet. One cup of coffee and a cigarette. One more time. Steve Warner on the guitar. A cigarette, waiting on the one I want to love and pet. Seems like a year since I've seen her face. Her sweet lips I can't wait to taste. Waiting on my baby, but she ain't here yet. One cup of coffee and a cigarette. Thank you very much. It's great to be here tonight on the anniversary of Marty's wonderful show here. This is my original guitar player, Steve Warner, on the guitar tonight. When we go out and do shows, our rockabilly shows, this is my front man, Paul Dragon. He's my Elvis singer. He sings just like Elvis. And this little band here is one of the best little rockabilly bands there are, and they're playing behind us tonight. They're on this show every week. Here's one of our best records, or called Everybody's Moving, goes like this right here.
You should be out there, George.
Well, it's Saturday night at the old dance hall. Rocking it up and having a ball. Well, the cats pick them up and then they lay them down. The music starts to really dig that sound. Everybody's moving, everybody's moving tonight. Yes, everybody's moving, everybody feeling just right. Yes, everybody moving tonight. Well, you grab your gal with all of your might. Well, you hug her once and then you kiss her twice. You tell her what she means to you, and then you really bop the blues. Everybody's moving tonight. Everybody's moving and everybody's feeling just right. Yes, everybody's moving and everybody's moving tonight. Hey, one time. You grab your gal with all of your might. Well, you hug her once and then you kiss her twice. Well, you tell her what she means to you, and then you really bop the blues. Everybody's moving, everybody's moving tonight. Yes, everybody's moving, everybody's feeling just right. Everybody moving tonight. Move it just one more time. Mm-hmm.
name is Johnny Cash. And right over here is June Carter Cash. Say something, June Carter Cash. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Well, it's Saturday night at the old dance hall. Rocking it up and having a ball. Well, the cats pick them up and then they lay them down. The music starts to really dig that sound. Everybody's moving tonight. Yes, everybody's moving, everybody's feeling just right. Yes, everybody's moving tonight. Yes, everybody's moving, everybody moving tonight. Everybody's moving, everybody's moving tonight. Yes, everybody's moving, everybody's moving tonight.
Microphone in here, Doc. How you doing, Glenn?
Doing real good, Marty, and it's good to be here with you tonight for your celebration.
Well, we're so glad to have you back. What do you got coming up real quick?
Did you see me go out there?
Oh. We're going to be doing a lot of shows like the House of Blues.
House of Blues.
And we're supposed to be going to Japan and stuff like that.
Japan?
Yeah.
That should be a
blast. So we got a lot of big shows coming up.
We want to go ahead and present you also with a plaque here on behalf of Marty's Corner.
Ooh, great.
For coming down to our third anniversary show. Glenn. Get a shot on the camera right here. Oh, I see the red light. Okay. Can you guys go ahead and play us? We can get out of here. Will you guys go ahead and play us a quick song, Dr. Break? Can you guys go ahead and do something for us real quick? Okay. So we're going to wait for a break. We're right back. Don't worry. Shields. If you're tired of this 5 days a week, join me on the weekend starting Friday, August 20th, 8 o'clock on Channel 33, Marty's Corner. I'll let you know what's going on this weekend before the weekend starts. This will be his sixth appearance on Marty's Corner. Sixth appearance on Marty's Corner. A very funny man and also a great impressionist. Can you please give a warm welcome to funny man Alex Pages. Alex, where you are, Alex? Alex, come on out. How you doing? Oh, I'll shake your hand. There you go. Alex, okay. Tear up. Okay.
How's it going, everybody? Hey, look, I didn't get a chance to check before I came out here. So maybe you guys can help me with this. Am I having a damn good hair day or what? I'm celebrating tonight, thank you. The last of my hair transplant.
Find him too.
Look good?
Is Frank here from PCI?
Thank you.
I don't know. Okay, we also need.
Well, you know, I had to be done. You know, I had to do this because it was getting a little embarrassing in social situations. For instance, you know, being at the beach and having all this hair on my ass. So You know what's really weird, though, is when people first see me, they can never figure out what I am. They'll look at me and they'll say, Mexican? Hawaiian? Filipino? Somebody even thought I was Chinese one day. Of course, it was really bright out that day. Actually, I'm Ecuadorian. I speak Spanish. No big deal. But you know what really irritates me? Is when people just automatically assume that I don't speak any English. For instance, the other day I was over at this restaurant. Okay, it was a fast food. All right, it was Taco Bell. The kid behind the counter takes one look at me. He goes, "That will be $2.65. Do you understand?" I'm like, "Yeah, what are you, retarded?" But then the owner comes over and says, "Actually, we hire the mentally handicapped." I'm like, "Oh." "Hey, look, kid, I'm sorry, I didn't know." He goes, "Oh, that's okay, you stupid beaner." So he's crippled now. Us Latinos, we've had our darker moments. In fact, I was in L.A. during the riots. I got to be honest with you, I was a little disgusted, you know, seeing people of my color robbing and looting. But the scariest part came when somebody actually took a shot at me. Hemming for that TV I was carrying, I'd be dead right now. Real violent out there, too. You got to be real careful. I was over at Brea Mall shopping, got into a fight over a parking space. Does this happen to anybody? I pulled into this parking space, right? This person gets out of their car, runs up to me, socked me in the stomach, popped me in the mouth, floored me. Man, I got so pissed off. I said, forget all that stuff they taught me about, you know, not hitting women. I kicked her 80-year-old butt all over that parking lot. Granddaughter gets out of the car, tries to start something with me, so I pick up grandma's cane and start hitting her with it. You know the white one with the red tip on it? Guys like impressions?
Yeah!
Okay, this is a real quick impression. Before I was a famous comedian, I used to videotape for a living. I used to do public service announcements, and I got to work with some celebrities. I got to work with Cheech and Chong. There's a safe sex commercial by Cheech and Chong. "Hey, wow, man, what are we doing?" "Hey, man, we're supposed to do a commercial for safe sex." "Okay, man, well, before you... Hey, man, you can say the F word on TV." "Okay, man, well, before you screw..." "Nah, you can't say that either." "Hey, why don't you do it, man?" "Okay. Before you, make love... make sure to put one of these on your wiener." Found out about a movie that's coming out pretty soon. I think you guys are going to really like it. They weren't going to make it, but they gave the guy a lot of money, and they let him write the script. So get ready next summer for Star Trek 10, The Wrath of Kirk. Here's a scene from that. Did you guys ever notice that Scotty always has this look on his face like he could use a little more fiber in his diet?
"Captain, I can't fix the transporter. I can't give you a war 5. Dr. McCoy smoked all the lithium crystals."
"Damn it, Scotty. Why is it that the only thing on my ship that works is your microwave oven and your refrigerator, you fat bastard?" "Lieutenant Uhura is suing me for sexual harassment. It's because I've boldly gone where no man has gone before." This is McCoy and Captain Kirk at the annual physical. Use your imagination. "Damn it, Bones, I've been coughing for 30 minutes. Let's get on with the examination. Let go of my egos. Aren't you supposed to wear a glove when you do that?" Yeah, that joke used to be so much funnier when I used to do it with my pants down. So, or when I was doing it in front of another audience. Okay, another real quick impression. I know you guys are staring at me, and I'm used to it. Because, in fact, when I found out I was going to sue, but I decided to do something constructive, I started a support group. You guys probably heard of it. Epic. Elvis Presley's Illegitimate Children. Well, thank you. We're 2,000 strong and growing every day. Now, what would the king of rock and roll... I just thought of that. I'm red tonight, ain't I? Am I a red Elvis? What would the king of rock and roll be doing today if he were still alive in the music industry? Well, you're about to find out. But before that, a little music, please. Favorite part. I did that in concert one time. It was really dark up here. I beat the hell out of my whole band. I'll be singing karaoke, which is Japanese for where's the friggin' band? This is on my new album. Hope you like it. Guy in the front row. You can stop staring at my butt now. Here we go. Well, since my baby left me, I found a new place to dwell. Down at the end of Lonely Street, it's Heartbreak Hotel. Though it's always crowded, you still can find some room for broken-hearted lovers who hide there in their gloom. Sapphire hops, tears keep flowing. Dusk works dressed in black. Been so long on Lonely Street, they're never coming back. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Alex Faith. Actually, these are my pajamas. There he is, sir. Marty Shield.
I'm sorry, Elvis. Alex Pages, they just shoved me out here, I don't know, huh? Right here, sir? Elvis has left the building. Elvis has left the building. I would like to go ahead and do one more video for you. I believe this is also the best of. Let's go and run that. And after we get down here, we're going to watch Bo Donaldson and the Haywoods. Let's go and take a look at this real quick. Take it away in the truck. Take it, boys.
Happy the clouds. In taking too much of that helium, I think. Happy, now what do you do exactly with all these beautiful balloons?
Well, I walk around the mall, smile at the children, wave to them, and try to sell balloons.
I think Happy spends too much time by himself.
What, who are you?
Hey, what is this? Do you have any favorite poems that you like to recite for the crowd?
No, I ain't got no poems.
No poems?
Guys, break a leg.
Do you know any poems you like to recite for us?
This is one of my favorite poems by Edgar Allan Poe. Then I would awake to the terror of the lone lake. Yet that terror was not fright, but a tremulous delight, a feeling not the jeweled mind could teach or bribe me to define, nor love, although the love were mine. Death was in that poisonous wave, and in its gulf a fitting grave for him who thence could solace spring to his lone imagining, and a solitary soul could make an Eden of that dim lake.
What kind of problems do seas have during the year as far as...
Oh, what I'm supposed to do is weigh each employee before they start shift and weigh them at the end to see how much candy they eat. No, I'm just kidding.
And do you find that they do that at Harvey's to pick up a couple pounds?
Yeah, over their time, I'm sure they do, but...
Do they hire thin people or heavy people here at seas?
They all look like they eat well.
Do you know what Kmart's price promise is?
Nope.
Hey guys, give the poor TV guys some space to skate.
We're now standing outside the Artist Hospitality tent. This is the place where all the big shots, all the big wigs are at. Only the top elite people of country western are inside here. Isn't this exciting?
John, you ready?
Scott, just get out. He's out of control. John, talking to Tom Wolpert. How you doing, Tom?
Tom, John, Bill, Frank. Yeah, I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm walking in a winter wonderland. Signpost up ahead, Christmasville.
Christmas come, but what's the year?
Let's talk about the specials here at Marty's. What about the Marty's Jumbo Burger? What's that? What's in a Marty Jumbo Burger?
Well, this is a nice and big hamburger.
Yeah. Pretty good?
Pretty good.
You ever had one?
Yeah.
All the time?
Not all the time, once
about,
in a while.
What about the club sandwich?
Club sandwich, that's good too.
It's good?
Yeah.
Is there anything you recommend here at Marty's?
Frisco burger.
Frisco burger's good?
Yeah, it's big enough for two people.
Big enough for two?
Yeah.
Over the crowd. And now we have a group who had the number one song for 2 weeks in America in 1974, and they're one of my favorite groups. So help me welcome Bo Donaldson and the Haywoods.
Mark, take it.
Yeah, we saw that one coming.
Billy's hand was up in a moment. Forget-
told how Billy died that day. The letter said that he was a hero. They should be proud he died that way. I heard she threw the letter away.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
How you doing, Marty? Good to see you too, buddy.
Bo, what do you guys got coming up real soon?
Oh, we've been playing some fairs and festivals around
the
West Coast.
You also have a new CD out. Why don't you take a look at that real quick? The Best of Bo Donaldson and the Haywoods. You can pick that up, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to be singing that song for about 2 weeks now in my head. I want to tell you.
Good.
We also have a plaque here for Bo Donaldson. Again, thanking him for coming down. Will you take that, Bo?
Oh,
huh? There we go, huh? Come on. Tough crowd.
Tough crowd.
Can you do a couple more songs for us?
We will.
Okay, is there again for Bo Donaldson and the Haywoods, guys? Take it away. Thank you very much.
This next song we're going to do went up to about number 12 on the charts and stayed up there a few weeks. This one's called Who Do You Think You Are? Thank you so much.
Hey, welcome to the Haywoods. We need to go out for a 3-minute break. Can you guys play us out real quick? Play us something. Thank you, Michael. Hit it, guys. Bo Donaldson. We'll be right back.
On Marty's Corner, a very talented and very funny man. Welcome with me, Rich Stein.
Thank you, Doll. Doll, thanks.
So welcome.
Hey, take it easy. I got to do 7 minutes. I already did two.
Work the crowd, Rich.
Ladies and gentlemen, the dysfunctional blues brother that never made it on the road. Yeah, that's right, folks. I lived in a tiny little crummy apartment for years in Huntington Beach. I hated to leave it because I had a great deal on an illegal cable hookup. Ah! Let's work the crowd here. Let's make these cameramen earn their money. Hey, how you doing? Nice to see you. See you at karaoke in El Monte after the show. All right. Hey, after this, we go to bingo. Then who knows what happens? Look at this. Oh, my God. I thought they enacted a curfew in this town. Hello, Pops. There's a special at Caro's, and they really do care. Oh, my God. Look at this. I don't want to... I'm only wearing this thing because, hey, folks, this year, Baldwin Park, who knows? Next year, Duarte. Come on, folks. Love Connection called. They're sorry they screwed up the date. Hello. We'll hook you guys up. You'll get the bikers. The Hells Angels are in town. Who knew they would allow a ponytail at the consortium at Baldwin Park? Oh, my God, look at this. It's a quilting society from over here in Pasadena. Nice that you showed up. Hello. It's nice to see people getting out of the house. There's more things to do on Saturday than watching that stupid lottery show and all those reruns of... Extra, an inside edition is just too much crap. Look, make these guys earn their money. Come on, they're busting out. I'm not going to just come up here and do jokes. Hey, there's a new invention, laundry soap. Yeah. Come on, folks. How you doing? Hey, I hook and I zing. Come on, it's love. Look at this kid. Hey, I know Nickelodeon, they do green slime, but you're wearing green earplugs. Get out of there. Oh, my God, look at... This is gonna be the mayor and the city council and all the rest of those people that bore us to death on that stupid show every week. How you doing? Oh, my... What are you, congressional candidate? Remember, politics comes from the root word poly, which means many, and ticks, which means blood-sucking parasites. Come on, we all know that. How we doing? Let's work our way to the back of the crowd, you know? I know babysitting can take out of the bills and the grocery. It can hurt. What's wrong with having a two-hour show and a baby cries for an hour and 75 minutes? How you doing, folks? Can I get you something like a watch? Come on in. There's more room up here. Let's slide up. Oh, my God. Look at this. The kids from the local. Hey, say, come on. Hey, man. I teach high school. I got this kid that comes in every day and goes, hey, dude. Hey, dude. See, that's funny to me. Kids get that. You old people from the quilting bee and the Caro's, don't crane your neck. I don't want to have to pay for a chiropractor Monday. I don't got work comp. I'm doing all I can do not to bomb in front of two kids that are 3 years old. They don't give a damn. Okay. Oh, my God, some of the people, you were already in the show earlier, right? Really? Either that or you've got some wacky tasting clothes, Charlie. Okay, we're kind of just working the crowd, working our way. See, this is what Donahue does. How are you doing? You look like a person who's interested in the show. I bet you want to be your own talk show host someday, right?
Yeah, of course.
And stage mom coaching her over here. Would you like to have your own show someday?
Maybe.
You got to put up with stuff like this. It's not easy. Maybe. Look at this. Oh, my God. Hey, I tell you, this guy's, hey, take it easy. Got the good group up here. We already covered green earplugs, the mayor, the congressional, the city councilman. We didn't talk to these guys over here. What's up? What's up? I saw you back there going to the metal detector. Ah, come on. There's a love and a humanity. Who is? Where's the mayor? You're the mayor of Baldwin Park? Yeah, that's close enough. I used to play Shout over there in West Covina. It was a swinging room. Hey, you know, I love that country music that last group was playing, huh? You know, they're combining country with rap. They call it crap. I don't know if you know that. Well, it's a pleasure for all of you guys to make it down here tonight. And I'm glad I made it up 2.5 hours into the show when they've figured out the audio technicalities or dysfunctionalities or... Is this on? Hello? But this is a real honor for me to be on the big
Marty's Corner.
Come on, folks, give it up, Marty's Corner. I was just going into my big closer. I thought I had a minute and a half left.
45, go.
Jeez. No, but you know what, folks? It's something for a guy like me to come down to a lovely little town like this and have all you guys show up on a Saturday night. Yeah, because, you know, folks, I'm not pro-life or pro-choice. I'm pro-Zach. Since I've been on this planet, 41 years, some of you young kids, I probably seem old to you. I'm at the age where everything's starting to click for me.
Let me know when to go.
He's chili dipping, he's stepping again. You know, first of all, the guy does a Bob Hope in the middle of my set like when he used to crash the Carson show. Thanks for the memory. Anyway, I, right in the middle of a joke, the audio and the hearing. Hey, why don't I just close the last segment? Come on, folks, what do you say? I got an hour and a half of material for crying out loud. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed. I wore my Sears action slacks with a Sansa belt waistline, and this short came off the rack at Zodi's in 73. Come on, folks, give it up. Joker, Joker, Joker. You gotta love a Zodi's reference. Anyway, I'm preparing for next Earth Day. I'm real excited. Last Earth Day, I don't know what you did. I took a dump and didn't flush. Folks. And let me ask you something. Do you ever have breakfast or lunch? You ever have lunch for breakfast? You ever have dinner for lunch, dinner for breakfast? Hey, Cliff, I think you're eating breakfast, lunch, and dinner 15 times a day. I think Cliff from IHOP is getting too much play. That's what I'm trying to make. That's the point I'm trying to make. Listen, it's so quiet in here, you can hear a career drop. Anyway, you know what I was... getting drunk earlier with a belly dancer in the green room. I thought to myself, how does a guy prepare for a set at the Baldwin Park Palladium? You know, you're dealing to a mixed crowd. You have your political hobnobbers over here. People trying to, you know, get some things passed. Grease the mayoral palm, if you would. This kid's laughing, he doesn't even know why. Anyway, I've got to go because I've got another gig next June, and I really got to be, I don't want to go over. I've enjoyed it. You guys are fun. Enjoy the rest of the show. Good night, folks. Hey, Marty.
Rick Stein, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to look at one more video clip, then we'll bring on Rosie and the Originals. Let's go ahead and run the video clip in the hall, and then we're going to have Rosie take it away, guys, in the truck, one more time. Two, three, four. Incredible camera. What kind of camera is this? Do you know?
This is your Sony Betacam Heathkit Slam-a-dam-a-dam-dam. Solid veneer.
I can tell. This is great.
Picked it up for a
song. We don't avoid any expense here on the corner, boy. We put out the big props, huh?
Of course, I made my big money in Eyewitness News, buddy.
Eyewitness News?
I used to
Jerry Dunphy and Christine Lund?
I learned how to focus a camera on his liver spots.
Take off, Mike, go! Go, Mike! Get out of here, Mike, go! Go! There you go! Crazy Mike! Go! Go!
He never took a lesson in his life, okay? That guy's 100% nice.
There he goes. Now, I'm warning all people there at Bill's Casino, keep your hands away from Mike's mouth at all times.
Don't try to set
him. Look at him, he's just nuts. He's got a chauffeur. They get, and they're off! They're off! They're on the way! They're on the way! We're going to talk to some people here in the canteen. Let's go this way with a good Ray and see who's in the canteen here with Marty's Corner. How you doing, sir? What's up?
Hey, man. How's it going, man? Marty?
Good to see you. What's going on here, Al?
There's too many goddamn Michael Jackson records in here. I don't see a single Elvis Presley record. What's going on here, man?
We're just over-rehearsed here in Marty's Corner. The Corner Band is going to be doing a song for us now. Like I said, we have five gentlemen sitting in for the Corner Band tonight. Right here.
And to sign up to walk, call 909-862-9900. 2971.
Thank you. Am I here also?
They're just changing us.
Okay. The Santa Anita Parkway's track.
Never.
Never rehearse a scene. You know, oh, is that me on TV? Gee.
Hey. Who's that good looking guy right there? Huh? Oh, yeah.
I look taller this way, but anyway.
And we have a gentleman on the show right now, Neil, Master of the Dark River, Neil! Neil, you're looking a little peaked these days. Neil, tell us a little about yourself, Neil.
Well, I am a 17th century warlock, horror host, cable access television. I get to go around and do all the weird stuff.
Yeah, right, dude.
Neil, Master of the Dark.
Neil, can you stay right there? How much time we have? Okay. How many are we out of time?
I'm not going anywhere.
6 minutes? 6 minutes?
6 minutes?
We're running long today.
You're running long today.
Really long.
But you're a French chef.
Yes, I was a 5 year fan, so I speak French.
You speak French too?
Okay, yeah.
Can you say something in French? Say I love Marty's Corner.
Bonsoir, Marty Corner. Oh. Bonsoir.
All right, yeah.
We're very, very excited about our next group of performers. As we said initially, she had a number one hit. In fact, she's also in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, Ohio. Can you please give a warm welcome to Marty's Corner to Rosie and the Originals. Take it away!
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. How are you folks doing? All right. Little surprise here for you. We've done a little recording. That was one of our new recordings that's soon to be released. And the next thing we have for you is a song that James Bentley here on keyboards wrote. It's called Just Take Your Time, and I hope you like it. We were so good, so good for so many years. The time we spent apart has made it clear. Together, where did it all go wrong? But I'll make it right, boy. I'll make it right. Don't answer now. Don't say goodnight. Just hold me like you used to do. And think it over. Think it over.
Just take your time.
I want you to think it over. Thank you so very
Rosie,
much.
Rosie, the original!
Thank you.
Thank you, Rosie.
Yes. Thank you very much.
We'd like to go and present you with a plaque also. On behalf of TCI and Marty's Corner, Rosie and the Originals.
Oh, well, bless your heart. Thank you. Oh, that's great. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Can you do that certain special song for us tonight?
I most certainly will.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, Rosie and the Originals. Take
Thank
it away,
you.
Rosie.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Right now, I'd like to take a special moment of time to introduce the nice fellows in the band. This is the new Originals. right here on the keyboard and horns and lead vocals, Mr. James Bentley. Thank you, James. Right here on my right, we have Mr. Jimmy. Congas. Our new addition to the band on drums is Joel Prescott. Right here on bass, lead vocals, Larry Turin. Thank you, Larry. And on lead guitar and vocals, Brad Pye. We're doing some new recording, and those are just a couple of the songs that we have on the album. They're still a little rough, but we're getting it, you know, and so we want you to look for that new album that we're putting out. Right now, I'd like to do Angel Baby for you. It's my pleasure to do it, and thank you for your support for all these years. I appreciate it, and I love you. Thank you.
Rosie and the Originals. Thank you so much. Thank you, Suzette.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can you guys play something after commercial real quick? Just something snappy and kind of something here? Well, here's something, boys. Just something here. Cool. We're going to wait for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back to close the show. Go ahead, take it away, guys. Clap it, everybody, clap it! Time to go ahead and say goodnight. We'd like to first of all thank all the people that have helped us come out here to the Ballpark Performing Arts Center. Mr. Bob Benbow, if he's in the audience, please come up on stage. Bob Benbow, the Director of Alternative Education. Bob, are you in the house? Bob, come on up. Come on up, Bob.
Now accepting on behalf of Bob Benbow.
How you doing, Bob?
Hi, how are you?
Fine. Thank you so much. We have to go and present you with a plaque.
I get to do it.
Why don't you turn on to the camera and see you here, Bob? We'd like to go ahead and also present you with a plaque here on behalf of Marty's Corner. Thank you to the Baldwin Park Performing Arts Center.
Yay!
And the Adult Continuing Career Training Center. Thank you so much for having us down. Why don't you stay right here, Bob?
Thank you for our wonderful, wonderful show.
Thank you so much.
I love this. Hope this happens every year.
Okay. Hey, invite us back. We also like to have a representative from TCI. TCI, is anybody here from TCI? Frank Maldonado or any of the executives? 2, 3. Anybody wants to come by from TCI? Oh, here we go. Here we go. Executive producer Bill Graves. Bill! You can hug her if you want. Politically correct. We'd like to also thank TCI for letting us do this show for 3 years and Bill to letting us do all the crazy stuff we do on the show.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Thank you.
And now, last but not least, as the hour is slipping away, I guess on behalf of Marty's Corner, would like to present to you for your third anniversary show, your plaque. There you are, sir.
No speeches. I would like to thank everybody who came down tonight. Thank you all for coming down tonight. Thank you.
Thank you to the audience.
Thank you, audience.
Thank you.
To my co-host Leanne Engel. Leanne. Our human.
Thank Carson.
Okay. Also our human applause machine, Crazy Mike over here.
Yay, Crazy Mike.
The Corner Band, Frank, Albert, Steve, and Oscar, huh? Good, Frank. All the volunteers, we have an all-volunteer staff and crew here on Marty's Corner. All the volunteers, thank you very much.
Yay!
For coming down. I'd like to thank my director, Skip. Skip, if you see us, wherever you're at, Skip, thank you so much, Skipper. Director on the truck, Skip. Our floor manager, a very beautiful lady, Carmen. Thank you so much, Carmen, wherever you are. Again, somebody speed it up. Also, the co-creator of Marty's Corner, gentleman who we wouldn't have been able to get this far with the show without his guidance and his technical ability. A very good friend of mine, John Carpy, our producer.
Yay!
John Carpy. Also, I'd like to thank Carmen for all of our musical equipment. Carmen, thank you, Carmen.
Yay!
It's getting hot up here. here. Is there anybody else I should thank? Anybody? Anybody? Oh, I'd like to thank myself? No, I don't want to do that. No. We like to go ahead and invite everybody to come back up on stage. We're going to do one more song for you. See us in October on Marty's Corner. And again, thank you all so much for coming down and supporting us and also supporting the small grants for literacy here in Baldwin Park. Gentlemen, could you please start it up? Come on up, everybody. Marty's Corner. Take care. God bless. Come on. Come on. You had died.